Hi guys, thank you so much for visiting my channel and welcome back to my channel. So this is a continuation of the previous video, the part one of this series. So where I used a Quest 3 headset to build our Unity program. So now if you have a VIVE headset, so for example, like if you have a Focus 3 or a VIVE XR Elite headset, so how can you do that? Okay, so to do that, I am basically trying to make this video a little bit shorter than the previous one. So if you want a more elaborated way of discussing all the things, you just go ahead and see the previous video and then come back to this video. But without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so now I already have downloaded the Unity Hub. Okay, and I already downloaded the latest version of Unity with the Android module attached to it. So again, if you do not have this Android module, we really need the Android module. So go ahead and download this the Android module. So you click on this settings window and then go to add modules, and then choose, you will see this like checkbox in front of the Android build support, and then like just like this, you just click on the Android build support and then it will select all these three options. Make sure all these three options are selected and then hit install, and then it will take some time to install all the Android modules for you. Once it is done, you will see just exactly like me. If you have a Mac, then you will see macOS and Android. If you have a Windows, then Android, Windows, and something else maybe. Okay, so now I just go ahead to project. I create a new project. Okay, and then similarly, I choose Universal 3D because we are going to use URP pipeline. Okay, choose wherever you want to save your project over here. Choose your Unity organization. Okay, and then give a name, like so I am using a Focus 3. So let's get started. So create project, and that will take some time to create the project. Once it is created, I will come back again. Okay, here we are back. So this is the project that we already opened. Okay, so now I am not going to say what these objects are and what the projects are, because we have already discussed it in the last video. If you do not see it, please go ahead and check it out. So now we are just going to install the packages that is necessary to make this simple project to a VR capable project for the Focus 3 headset. Okay, so to do that, we go to Window Package Manager, and then we choose this drop down menu, select Unity Registry, and then go to XR Plugin Management and install it. Okay, so it is installed. Now go to XR Interaction Toolkit and then install it. So now it will ask you to restart the editor. Yes, we are going to restart the editor to make sure everything is installed properly. So go ahead and hit the yes button. Okay, so now we are back again. So now again, we are going to choose XR Interaction Toolkit, and then this time we choose samples over here, and then we download the starter assets. This starter assets will consist of some important things, important input actions and all the stuff that we are going to use in our project. Okay, so now again we go to Package Manager, and then go to TextMesh Pro. And then if you have to update, it will show it here. For me, yes, it is currently installed as 3.0.6, but there is an update available, so we go ahead and then install the update. Okay, so now once it is done, so we can close the Package Manager. Now we need to go to File, Build Settings, and then we need to change the project to Android, because remember the Focus 3 is an Android based device. So we switch platform, and it will take some time to switch the platform to Android. Once it is done, we can come back. Okay, so it is done. How can you say that it is done? This small Unity icon has shifted from Windows to Android, and thus you know, like, the device, the Unity is basically going to deploy all of your app game to Android now. Okay, so now we click on player settings over here, and that will create this project window. For your case, you may see the project window as a separate window. You just simply like in this way, like this way. Okay, what I did is like I just simply click and hold on this tab, and they just put it over here. Okay, why I did that? Because this project setting is like very essential part of a game development procedure. So that's why I just put it over here, so that it will be much more easier to use, rather than every time going to here, click on build settings, and then clicking on player settings. Okay, so now here we need to go to package manager. Okay, and then there are three options here. We need to fill out some down information. So name is VIVE, all in capital letters. Then URL is https://npm-registry.vive.com. Okay, and then scopes is com.htc.upm. Okay, once you fill up this information, click on save. Okay, it will load something, and then to see what happened over here, we go to window, package manager, and then again click on this Unity registry, and this time you see this new option called my registries, which was not there before. If you click on it, you will see all the HTC packages shown up over here. So now we do not need all of them, we only need these three packages. Okay, so we click on essence and then install, and I hope that all the three packages will be installed if I click on essence. Let's see. Okay, so as you can see, all the three packages are installed. Okay, but it also gives you a dialog box over here. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to choose whatever buttons they have given. We need to choose that. So it says use recommended ARM64. Yes, we are going to choose that. Use recommended IL2 CPP. Yes, we are going to choose that. Use recommended landscape left. Yes, we are going to choose that. And then finally, use recommended API level 25. We can choose that, but sometimes it create a problem. Okay. So, but for now we can choose that, and then close. If we find a problem, we will show you like how to get rid of that problem. Okay, so now I can close it, and then we come over here to web access settings. Now if you are using a VIVE Focus 3 with the eye tracking module on, or a face tracking module on, then you have to turn on these options. So I have an eye tracker module, so I can just simply turn on these two options. If you have a face tracker, you can turn on the lip expression and all those stuff. Okay. Now you can also turn on hand tracking if you want. So I can turn hand tracking. If you have a VIVE trackers and all those stuff, you can turn on trackers. Okay. Now I go to project validation, and then it says that we have to fix one problem. So I click on fix all, and that will click create, like remove all the problem, because it will fix it. Okay, now we go to XR plugin management, and then from here we need to choose one option. So you see this Wave XR. So Wave XR is for VIVE, so we need to turn on this Wave XR package, so that the VIVE headset can detect whatever game you are going to deploy. Okay, so now, okay, so when you are done with XR plugin management, choosing the Wave XR, you just need to select each of these options, the Essence, Native, and XR SDK. When you select one option, you will see something is loading like that. Okay, it will take some time, And then once I have done all these three, I will come back. Okay. So everything is done now. Now I need to go to time. And then here by default, the fixed time step is 0.02, which we need to change it to 0.00833333. Now, why did we change that? So, you know, all the games runs in every frame. So Unity runs every code that you are going to write in future in every frame. So, your device has a refresh rate, right? Like 90 hertz per second or 120 hertz per second. So that means every update is happening between 1/120th second, if it is a 120 hertz refresh rate. So if you do the calculation, so 1/120, so that is 0.00833. So VIVE Focus 3 supports 120 hertz refresh rate. So that's why I put this value as the fixed time step over here, so that the update is like, make sure that all of your updates are happening within this time frame in every frame. Okay. Then go to player to see if everything is working properly or not. Now, the minimum API level is by default set up to API level 25. So for now, we do not put anything over here. While deploying, if we find some problems, we need to change it to API level 32. But let's see what happens. Okay. Now, one more thing we need to change over here is active input handling. By default, it is set to both, but we need to change it to input system package new. Okay, so go ahead and do that. And once you do that, it will ask you to restart the headset for application of this option. So we just go ahead and apply. Okay, so we are back again. So now most of the headset, so most of the project is basically set up. Now we need to create a camera, a VR camera in the scene. Okay, so now I right click on the hierarchy and then go to XR and then choose XR Origin VR. That will create a VR camera in this scene. Okay, so now if we, by selecting the XR Origin, we go to inspector and then we choose the tracking origin mode to floor. Why we chose that? Because whenever you are going to give this game to your friends, to other people, when they will download it, if you choose the tracking origin to mode to floor, the headset will automatically detect the height of the person from the floor. Okay, so that means the height adjustment will be automatically done. If you do not choose it to floor, you have to manually write a script for doing the height adjustment calculation. Now, under XR Origin, you will see camera offset, main camera, the left controller, and the right controller. So the VR camera rig is set up. Okay. But the problem is, you see the left controller and the right controller are basically empty over here. Okay. So now we need to set up the controller so that it can detect the whatever buttons you are pressing. And then based on that, you get the input into your device. Okay, so how to do that? I just select the left controller and then click on this small tiny little option and then select left controller and then see all of the input actions are automatically popped up here. Okay, similarly, I go to right controller, click on here and then select right controller and then it automatically detects everything for you. Okay, fine. So now I go ahead and then delete the main camera because this we do not need. This is the like normal by default camera, which is mainly meant for desktop or laptop based, like screen based system. But we are going to deal with VR headset, so we do not need the main camera. So it was deleted. So we have a VR camera. Now we can just simply create a plane to give you a little bit view, better view. So you go to 3D object and then click on plane. Okay, so now it is, see, it is located at 000, which is fine, which we want, and the XR origin is also at 000. So we just save it by pressing Command S or Control S for Windows. How do you know it is saved? If there is no star over here, so that means your scene is saved. If there is a star, so that means the scene is not saved. Whenever you need to save the scene in order to build the project, okay? So now let's see what happens when we go to the build. So once we are there, click on development build, okay? Now click on refresh. So, and then plug in your device plug in your HTC VIVE Focus 3 with your computer. It will ask you, like, do you want to allow the headset to detect the computer? You say yes. And then finally, there will be three options: file manager and something else. Just choose file manager to store all of your data and to deploy your application onto headset. Choose file manager for that. Okay. So now you see, when you click on this drop down menu, then you can see the HTC VIVE Focus 3 when you give permission to the computer, and then you choose file manager from the drop down menu inside the headset. Now I click on this HTC VIVE Focus 3, and then for the first time, before we have not built any game from this Unity application, right? So we click on build, and then we click on new folder. We create a new folder called builds, and then inside the builds folder, we just create an application called test application. And then see, we get our first error. How to get to see the first error? We go to console, and then it says API Vulkan is not supported any of the current loaders. Okay, so now to solve this problem, we go to project settings and then player, and then we remove the Vulkan because it says the selected graphics API is not supported. Okay, so we just remove it, and then only OpenGL ES will be there. So now let's see what happens. Okay, so now if you see a dialog box like this, add interaction manager, so you just click on okay. Okay, so when all the loading is done, you will see the APK file shows up over here. So now we need to deploy it. Okay, so now again we go back to the Unity software. We just click on refresh over here, and then if you do not already select the HTC VIVE Focus 3, just select the HTC VIVE Focus 3 again, and then we can select patch and run or patch. Patch means it will only install the application on your device, and patch and run means it will install and it will run in the device. Okay, so I just go ahead and then click on patch and run. Okay, so we are there. Okay, so now as you can see, everything is working, but the problem is I could not cast my HTC VIVE Focus 3 on my computer, so I am basically showing casting from my Quest 3, but basically we are able to see the same thing inside the HTC VIVE Focus 3. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. See you in my next video. Thank you.